Alright, quick question for the internet here. What does it mean to create something truly original? I'm gonna answer that question in this video. But to start off, I'm gonna sort of put this out there. And it's gonna sound really crazy at first, but it's gonna start to make sense the more you watch this video, okay? I think true originality is just fucking stupid. Like actual true originality. Something that's never been created before. So when you ask the question, what does it mean to be truly original? I think most people would probably answer by saying, to create something original, you have to create something that nobody else has created, like ever. But if you ask me, I think true originality doesn't really exist. I mean, I suppose it could exist, but you'd have to really go out of your way to make it exist. Like, I don't know, maybe create a new language? How about a new style of music? Screw rock and hip-hop, dude, I'm gonna create a fucking carpet jam. It's gonna sound like this. Is that original enough? Even then though, I think it's pretty fucking hard to come up with something completely original. Like, have you ever tried to, I don't know, conceive of a new color? Like, have you ever tried that? You ever tried to, like, think, like, super hard, see if you could, like, think of a new color or something? Yeah, it's not possible, okay? It's actually not. So, don't try. Don't actually waste your time. I tried that for a really long time once when I was little. I would dedicate, like, solid fucking hours to, like, trying to find a new color in my head. Can't do it. Just can't do it. It's like a blind person trying to conceive of colors, just period. Like, your brain can't really conceive of things that it's not been exposed to in the world. So what you can do is think of originality as a culmination of like different ideas and stimuli that your brain has already been exposed to. Like you can mix red and yellow and make orange, but you still had the red and yellow to start with. Like if you hadn't seen those colors, does that make sense? I guess it does, I'm just sort of rambling. Think of originality as like a cake. So every cake is made from a unique combination of like eggs, flour, milk, and sugar. The ingredients all came from different places, but it was how they were combined that sort of made the cake. So in the same way, every original idea can be traced to its roots. Think about a car, for example. The car has roots. The car didn't just sort of spawn out of nothingness. Car has an engine. Car has windows. Those are all ideas, individual ideas that came from other ideas, that came from ideas before that. All the ideas are intertwined and laced into like earlier ideas. Now when I say true originality is stupid, it's because something truly original is just not relatable in any way. Here's an example of something that's truly original. Let me show you a fucking example of what that would look like. Yeah, that was random noise. How relatable was that? Was that original enough for you guys? Did you enjoy that fucking shit? It was original, right? It was completely original. It was content that you've never seen before. All of those pixels were oriented in a way that had never been viewed by any other person ever. Totally 100% original. That means it's good. Now, ideas, they can be original. You can have thoughts that are your own. I mean, everyone is original in their own way. Like, they have their own thoughts and their own life experiences contribute to their views of the world. 'Cause you are special. But format is a different thing. So I recently made this video, Combo Dumbo Exposed. I put in the video, you know, don't fucking call me Leafy. I don't want to hear that I'm Leafy. Because it was sort of in the Leafy style. It was like the Leafy format. You know, you get behind a camera, you start talking for a little bit about a certain topic, and you play a game while you're talking about the topic. That's a Leafy format. But the thoughts in the video were my own. They were based on my own original ideas. Just used in, like, that format. And I said in the video that it was a good way to present those thoughts. And I think it is. So if I were to come up with an original format, it would look a little bit fucking crazy. Because the format has already been sort of decided by other people who are better than me at making videos. Let's go back to that car analogy. What if you had to come up with a new format to design a car every time you made a new car? Like, what if you had to, like, redesign the engine and, like, redesign fucking windows, make them out of diamonds? That sounds pretty original. No, it's stupid. If it's a good format, you use it. That's how we grow as people. We teach others, especially in the film industry. Film especially is a perfect example of how you learn from people in the past. Film has evolved from people learning from other people who have done it better. So like Steven Spielberg, he's really pretty much revolutionized the film industry. He's changed the way people make films. He's created a really nice format to make films. Like his films, they look good, and people can see that they look good, and they want to make their films look good. So they use his format. I'm not denying that I'm using Leafy's format, it's just a good format. He taught something to the internet, basically. You look at a Leafy video, you like a Leafy video, and you want to make a video like Leafy. But you don't use Leafy's thoughts, you don't use his ideas, you use your own personal ideas and thoughts. They're your own unique, original thoughts, opinions, life experiences, and that's what makes true originality. So earlier I mentioned a video that I made a while back, Combo Dombo Exposed. In this quote, Leafy style video, I did Pac-Man gameplay. I actually did that for a reason, because I wanted to make this video later on, and I knew that I could use that as a point. So here's the point I was making by playing that Pac-Man game. So people on the internet are pretty obsessed with originality, wouldn't you say? So if I would have done CSGO surfing in that video, I would have gotten called out so hard, I would have been a Leafy copy. But what's wrong with playing CSGO? It's a popular game. It's a good game. Did you guys enjoy that fucking Pac-Man gameplay? Nobody else has done that. That's pretty original, if you ask me. Nobody else has done a Pac-Man commentary gameplay. That's original. But it's shit. People have already figured out what's entertaining. Who wants to watch Pac-Man?
There's no Pac-Man channels out there. I better do a Pac-Man fucking channel.
Why stop there? I'm gonna make a fucking Galaga Let's Play series. That's original, isn't it? In other words, if I know I can make a video more entertaining by using a certain format, I'm not gonna go out of my way to make it less entertaining just to be original. That's just fucking stupid. Come on, guys. Alright, you guys, that's my rant on originality. Despite the fact that I did get a few, you know, leafy and cringe comments, which they're gonna come along with just about every video you see these days, despite that, you guys, for the most part, really enjoyed my Combo Dombo Exposed video. So if you guys also enjoyed this video, I might give rants a shot. I tried to do rant videos in the past, and they haven't actually done very well, but that one did really well. And I'm not sure if that's because I've gotten better at making rants, I have more subscribers, or I'm just making rants on sort of interesting topics, I don't know. Anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this video, let me know by leaving a like. That's the only way I can know.
But in all seriousness, guys, thank you so much for watching. You guys have been actually fucking amazing recently. So thank you guys so much. And as always, guys, keep it fresh.